Okay, so welcome everyone to the third meeting of 2023 of the Delegated Powers and Law Reform Committee. We've received apologies today from our convener Stuart McMillan, MSP, and in his place can I welcome Jenny Minto, MSP. Welcome to Jenny. Before we move on to the first item in the agenda, I would like to remind everyone present to switch mobile phones to silence, which I've just done. And the first item of business is a declaration of interest in accordance with Section 3 of the Code of Conduct. And I invite Carol Mockin, MSP, to declare any interest relevant to the remit of the committee.
Nothing to declare. Thanks, convener.
Thank you. Thank you, Carol. And I welcome Carol Mockin to the committee. Before we move on to the next item in the agenda, I would like to take this opportunity on behalf of the committee to thank Paul Sweeney for his contribution to the work of the committee. And I know that Paul will do well on whatever committee he moves to. Second item of business is to decide whether to take items 5, 6, 7 and 8 in private. Is the committee content to take these items in private? And we are. Thank you very much. So under agenda item 3, we are considering two instruments subject to the affirmative procedure, and no points have been raised on the draft Community Care, Personal Care and Nursing Care Scotland Amendment Regulations 2023 and the draft Civic Government Scotland Act 1982 Licensing of Short-Term Lets Amendment Order 2023. Does anyone have any comments to make on these matters? Yeah, Oliver Mundell.
Yes, convener, in relation to the second instrument, I just wanted to put on record that although I will be supporting the instrument and recognise that the six-month extension will make a big difference to a number of individuals but not solve all the problems, I think this instrument could have been avoided if concerns raised by the Short-Term Lets Association and other industry stakeholders had been taken into account when this licensing scheme was first proposed. I therefore think the delays and challenges we're seeing now were entirely predictable, and I think it's something where the Scottish Government needs to refocus its efforts on rebuilding those relationships with stakeholders. Thanks.
Okay, a note has been taken of that. Any further comments at all? No further comments have been raised on these two instruments. So is the committee content that we move forward? Thank you. Under agenda item 4, we're considering two instruments not subject to any parliamentary procedure, and no points have been raised on SSIs 2023 3 and 4. Is the committee content with these instruments? And we are. And thank you very much indeed. So I move the committee into private, and thank you.